Yes, guys.
Okay, so hello everyone. So yeah, today's our theme is how do entrepreneurs go about building an effective team? Okay, this will be our the topic for the assignment today. And we have with us Gaurav Agarwal. He's the founder, co-founder of Co-Founders Planet, recently a startup which has recently been established, and a long-held startup, SMV Consultants. So his expertise is in human resources. How to, like, Co-Founders Planet is basically about how it's like a matchmaking platform for co-founders. So that is the basic gist of Co-Founders Planet. So our first question will be, like, at SMVA, it's regarding SMVA, you have, like, assisted 850 plus companies across 15 plus countries in the recruitment process. So being an entrepreneur, what were the key points in your mind while building your own team for such a huge task?
For these things, first of all, there should be a vision match. Okay. So that as SMB consultants, we are into the process of helping candidates get the right job. So in that process, everyone first should relate to that process itself. That boss, I'll have to match a company with a good candidate. That is the first requirement. So we understand that from the candidate's perspective, whether they relate to the recruitment process or not. So in our sense, we use the term DNA fit. If somebody understands our processes, understands our vision, that is where we call them, okay, this fellow is a DNA fit for our company. So that is, I believe, the core for any, you know, team member, for at least SMB consultant.
Also, Gaurav, we read that 23% of the startups fail because the team is not right. So what were the difficulties faced by you when you organized your own team initially? What were the hurdles that you faced?
Actually, the problem is everybody is persuaded by the news that are flashing. So what actually happens is people are one thing called a survivorship bias. So what happens in the survivorship bias is, so, you know, right, many people are, say, 100 people are on a boat, okay, or a ship, and 95 people actually sink in, and 5 people who actually survive, the stories flashed by those 5 people will only be circulated all across the media. Same is the startup world or the business world. So the flashy stories are so flashy that every employee want to switch from the hurdles and the struggles of his current startup and want to move to a very flashy world. In Hindi, we always say, "Dusre ki thali mein ghee zyada lagta hai." So it is as simple as that. So people always relate that, okay, my current startup probably is not providing me enough to sustain. Or probably I deserve much more. Rather, the thought process for any candidate should be, boss, do I deserve that or not? I need to make myself more deserving. I need to enhance my skills. If I work upon myself, I will be more capable. Probably the current compensation that I am getting or the current designation or position that I am holding is because of my skill set. So the improvement of the skill set should be what anybody should focus on. So that is, I believe, a big mismatch which often happens, that, you know, this flashy news and everything is there. So people often, you know, think about changing company. You know, like in our father's time, there was a concept of Munimji, that Munimji used to stay for 20, 25 years or even, you know, 30, 35 old years. But now the concept is no more existing. People switch and change the jobs way too fast. There is nothing called stability, right? So that is why, you know, that stable people, because understand, there is too much of thing that goes inside building a core team. And if the core team itself keeps on changing and rotating, it's lost. So startups fail mostly because of that particular perspective or that particular angle as well. Because the team which was there at the very initial stage is itself, you know, making so many switches, making so many of changes. That thought process is taking too much of switch in a way.
Okay. I had one follow-up question to the earlier question which we asked. So, what helped you build your own team? Like, what did you search for in your co-founders, or how did you come about it?
Right. So, I will actually talk about my recent experience only for adding my co-founders. So, I narrated my story to them, to be very honest. I told them, boss, this is my background. This is my LinkedIn profile. This is my everything. You read about me. Next, I obviously give them sort of a presentation of what I am looking at. I consider the core team members as my investors. I'll tell you why. Investors invest money. Core team people invest their time. Right? This is a very, you know, important concept which everyone, I think, should consider. Your core team is as important as your investors. So I consider them as my investors. I pitch them. Literally, I pitch them. So they understand about me. I actually pitch them about our company, our details, what is my vision, how I see that company after 2 years, 3 years down the line. How am I, you know, why I started that, all those kind of questions. Then once they are convinced, then we can think about probably, okay, hey boss, this is a decent guy, has got a decent profile, good background, good academics and all those things. And now we can think about, you know, getting on the same kind of a boat as well. So it's actually like a simple matchmaking concept. Now, again, a disclaimer here. I'm talking about this discussion, this kind of a detailed discussion with a core team people, as in the co-founder level people. But the same case, when I hunt for probably my, you know, same team, like employees in case of SMBA consultants, so that way the table sort of turned, because the legacy is there. It has been 8.5 years, so we are already there in the market. You can Google it, Google us up. We are a 40 plus network and all those things is already there. So people have already studied about us. They have applied, right? So there we actually try and find out, this is our requirement. Say I'm looking for somebody for developing my franchises, or I'm looking for somebody to manage my social media handle. So my requirements are clear. I clearly try to find out a simple match. But these are my shoes to fill. Can you do that or not? So I mean, that is how, you know, the two entities and the approaches essentially differ.
Gaurav, as you said that the core team invests their time. So there might have been instances where this core team had faced some issues. So can you please elaborate on some of the issues that you faced?
See, core team, one of the prime issues that we often face or have faced very recently is some of the skill sets that we have to outsource. Okay. Basically, to judge that right kind of a service provider has become a good challenge for us. Because understand, the service, say for example, I give a software project to somebody. And that, in fact, you know, before the call only, I was talking to this one of the vendors who was talking about his all those things. Trust me, this is the third service provider I'm talking to for the same requirement. So that is a big challenge. To actually locate that kind of a service provider, because your core team, it is not possible to have all the skill sets. And the business essentially requires most of the skills to be in place to run that particular business very smoothly. So that is one particular challenge, as you pointed out, that is there. The skills that are not present in the core team needs to be outsourced, and to actually find that right outsourcing guy. So that is a major chunk of problem, I would say.
But within your team, have you faced certain challenges? Like sometimes it happens that you're onboarding some new franchisee, or you have some new projects which are ongoing, or you are trying to get some new project or idea, anything. So there are certain clashes in the ideas, because other person might think, no, this is not the way to go about it. There might be certain disagreements. So have you faced such disagreements, and how did you resolve those?
I'll actually tell you, if you ask about the SMBA, so when we initiated the franchising, most of the people scrapped the idea. Most of the people told, boss, this is not going to work. Franchising concept work in the food business. You talk about McDonald's, you talk about Domino's. It works very well there. Who is going to buy your franchise? So what actually happens is, it becomes the conviction of the founder there, how confident he is to run behind that idea. So we started off, and I would say a combination of hard work and a bit of destiny, that we became the fastest growing franchise network as we are now. So I mean, I would say that conviction part might not be there with most of them. Most of the people might not agree to the new part, new segment that you are planning to enter. But I mean, that time you need to take sometimes that hard call that let us go forward with it, even if some of them do not agree, but let us take that plunge. And that ownership has to be there, to be very honest. If that clicks, I mean, everybody will be there with you. And if that doesn't, I mean, you need to be ready to actually hear those kind of, cuss words and all those kind of different angles, sort of things. So that is a particular thing. I mean, to summarize it, entering into a new segment and diversification, and there definitely, there might be differences of opinion. Yeah.
With this, I get reminded of one of your articles. You talked about importance of cultural fit while recruiting. So how do you ensure that someone you are taking on board will be the right fit for your startup, will be the right fit for your team?
Right. So, as I told, I was discussing with you guys only, that the information is widely available. So say, for example, I mean, just after my session, I want to say Google Pulkit Singhal or Prakriti Jain. I can easily track them on Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram, and all those, depending on how active you are. So if you guys are very active there, I can look up to your profiles. I can understand that these guys are very socially active, right? So, and if you guys are not there, that is also again a sign that probably digitally these fellows are not very active. So, I mean, in this process also, I found out one skill of yours, that is being digitally active. Right? So, like this, whenever we actually try to find a particular candidate, we try to actually check multiple things. What kind of family background they are having? Where are they coming from? Where they see themselves 3 years, 5 years down the line? What kind of strengths they are having, what kind of, we also put them in some hypothetical scenarios. And we always tell them, this is a startup with limited resources. Please be ready for that. Do not presume that this is a bed of roses or this is a very hi-fi kind of a corporate office with 500, 1000 employees and you are gonna, get all these things. So you have to hustle from day one. So that culture, we try to tell them from day one. Because what happens is, if you under-promise and over-deliver, people will like it. On the other hand, if you stay, if you show them a very flashy picture from day one, boss, you're going to get so much of goodies, there are festivities there and all those things. So, if they do not get that kind of thing, they already have that set expectations, understand? So if you do not meet that, you're going to anyway go down. So we try and keep that very undertone, and when they receive those kind of extra things, they feel good about it because they'd never expected it, right? So I mean, this kind of culture, and if you actually go to our social handles and all those things, our culture actually is very, very transparent, and we never use the term, say, employees, etc. We always say SMBA family, right? So that is our culture. And I mean, we try and find that, hey, whether these people fit into that kind of culture or not. So that is very important culturally. That is why I'll always say, see what your culture is and whether that kind of person will be able to, you know, understand your culture and be in that kind of a culture or not. So I have multiple examples. Honestly, I could cite that one as well. So one of the manufacturing units here in Calcutta, so one of the fellows, to be very honest, who went there, he came back after day one, said that, okay, the washroom is not very clean there. So understand, I mean, that might be a very, you know, irritating excuse that fellow is making. But when we understood that, oh, hey, this is a reason, no doubt. Washroom not being very clean is a reason. But on the other end, the candidate also needs to understand the fact it is a manufacturing unit. And instead of coming back and not probably, you know, blaming, you know, multiple people about it, not, he could have spoken to his colleagues there and asked, what is the next solution? How people resolve this particular thing? You know, I mean, that is where the culture thing comes up. I mean, what kind of culture you have seen at your home? Whether you are from a five-star background or whether you are probably from a very decent background, a humble background. So then probably you can easily adjust to those kind of circumstances also. I mean, that is where cultural fit is very, very critical, to be very honest.
Okay, so the next is about how do you keep your team motivated at all times, like towards the goal of your startup?
So we follow a very transparent culture, honestly. So what we do is, every morning we have a group meet. So now even during the virtual, you know, season, 10 a.m. is the fixed virtual meet for every team member. Plus, we, you know, often try and mention that, you know, guys, let us come on video. We often promote that kind of thing. Please, we cannot talk to just, you know, probably now is the time when we might not just shake hands, right? So if we see each other every day, that culture still remains. Plus, we believe in listening to their problems also. So there are some people, I mean, you know, in our team itself, probably crossed the age of 55, 56. So probably double of my age. So, I mean, it's completely okay, right? So we need to understand what they feel about the company, how we are going, what is their, you know, way of approaching stuff. So it is a very inclusive culture. So if you actually are transparent, inclusive, the team is always motivated, to be very honest. Now, if you try and play hide and seek, say that, okay, these are the things which I'm going to say to my team. These are the things which are trade secret. These are the things packed in my Godrej box. It isn't going to work that way. Be very transparent with them. Be very, very clear that the team is not performing well. The company's financials are weak or are going strong. Plus, I mean, we often follow a thing of organizing games. So we always try and gamify stuff. What we do is say there is a team of 20 people are there in the coding, for example. So we divide them into two teams. We organize, say, whoever wins, they will get a dinner voucher. So they go out. Okay? You know, so those that kind of a bonding remains. Plus, when the entire thing is getting gamified, you know, that school kid is always there within us. Even if you become cross 50 or whatever, that gamification will always sort of get that kick to us. So, I mean, we often believe in those kind of tricks. Plus, you know, we often, these small things also make a difference. Say, for example, sharing your own family thing. Say, a newborn is there, or probably some activity is happening, calling them over, having probably, you know, discussing, showing them a picture of your niece. Hey, I mean, my niece is born. I mean, these small things make so much of a difference that they actually feel very much a part of the family. And you may not actually, when the things are very inclusive and transparent, they are like a family, you know, so they are always motivated. And you know, you cannot keep themselves motivated forever because you yourself might be down as well. I mean, it's always a plus and, you know, that kind of a ride, the bumpy ride. But yes, you need to see often the things are motivated.
I think that would be all, Prakriti. Are there any other questions?
Not really. Gaurav elaborated it very well, and the online scenario we can also relate to very much, like keeping ourselves up during these times. So it was a very nice interview. We got a very really nice insights. Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot, Gaurav, for your help.
Thanks, guys. And all the best for your upcoming sessions. And I believe the placements and everything all are kicking off. Or has it already been done?
We are undergoing the placement season already.
So, okay. All the very best. Hope you guys see and, you know, track some really good ones. Any help you require with respect to probability.